Dear Excellencies, dear ladies and gentlemen, how many female leaders do you know within your network? When you really think about it, what have you done to make space for girls and women in leadership roles at your institution or organization? My name is Margot and I'm 24 years old. I could say I was lucky. I benefited from the right to education and it has defined my life. It is a reason why I'm proud today to address you as a young woman, as a researcher in educational sciences, and as a youth activist from Plan International. It is my education that gave me the opportunity to be here today on the invitation of Minister Ketir, who has put children's and girls' rights at the center of her policy. So again, you could maybe say I was lucky, but honestly, I shouldn't feel that way. For the world to change, we must strengthen girls' leadership opportunities and listen to girls' voices and experiences to ensure that their needs and problems are addressed. Listening to girls' voices should not be restricted to a symbolic action. I wonder, what efforts have you made to create meaningful participation in your respective capacities? And could this forum be a first step? Today, girls and women are leading global movements. Think of the hashtag MeToo movements or actions against climate change. Girls and women are change makers. They influence decision-making at many levels and even change prevailing gender norms. But this is not something that can be taken for granted. Even now, in 2021, women are still heavily underrepresented in leadership roles. For example, only 25% of parliamentarians worldwide are women. We must shift to a society where girls and women are involved in decisions about their lives and their education. The COVID-19 pandemic has led to extreme poverty, and it has reduced educational opportunities of children, especially girls. Worldwide, millions of girls will not return to school after the pandemic. And it's not just a pandemic that has catastrophic consequences. Do you know how many women are displaced by climate change? 80%. 80% of all displaced people in the world are women. Therefore, let's start today to work towards meaningful participation on three levels. At the individual level, girls must be given the space to be authentic and to develop individually, free from gender norms, violence, or discrimination. At the school level, teachers must educate girls to become critical and active citizens. They should provide a democratic learning environment in which students develop participation and decision-making skills. At the policy level, girls must be involved and given ownership of decisions that affect their lives in a structural and sustainable way from both an education and climate policy perspective. Each and every girl is a powerful change agent and must be educated equally. I am here today not just to pronounce these words. I am here today to demand action. Now, more than ever, we need to continue to invest in girls' education. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I am here talking to you today and it's my right, but it should not be an exception. I should not be an exception. The rights of girls and all children should not depend on luck. The rights of girls and children wherever may never depend on luck. I thank you all for listening.